गुड मॉर्निंग, आई एम डॉक्टर राजेश्वरी हेगड़े, प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड टेलीकम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग, बीएमएस कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, बैंगलोर। द टॉपिक ऑफ माय प्रेजेंटेशन इज एनश्योर हेल्थी लाइव्स एंड प्रमोट वेल बीइंग फॉर ऑल एट ऑल एजेस, दैट इज सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल 3। नाउ लेट अस लुक एट व्हाट आर सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल्स। The 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development, adopted by all United Nations member states in 2015, provides a shared blueprint for peace and prosperity for people and the planet now and into the future. They address the global challenges we face, including poverty, inequality, climate change, environmental degradation, peace and justice. Now let us look at this good health and well-being. Good health and well-being requires mental and physical fitness. We do exercise, take good food to keep our physical body fit, but many times we hardly take care of our mental health. A person's mental health is defined by his cognitive, behavioral, and emotional well-being. This includes how a person thinks, feels, and behaves. Some people use the term mental health to mean the absence of a mental disorder. It affects daily life, relationships, and physical health. According to the International Covenant on Economic, Social, and Cultural Rights, every human being has the right to the best possible health without regard to race, religion, political belief, economic, or social conditions. In order to fully enjoy other human rights, the right to health must be fully realized. In this sense, good health is an end in itself and it plays a vital role in human capabilities and well-being. Health is central to the three dimensions of sustainable development, that is, economic, social, and environmental. According to World Health Organization, health is defined as the state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being, not merely the absence of disease or infirmity. So these three factors, physical, social, and mental well-being, all are interconnected. They depend on each other. Health is a quality of life involving social, emotional, mental, spiritual, and biological fitness on the part of the individual, which results from adaptations to the environment, whereas wellness refers to the achievement of the highest level of health in each of several key dimensions. What is sustainable health? Despite the pandemic of obesity and stress-related illnesses like high blood pressure, heart disease, cancer, and diabetes that is sweeping the Western world, we take our health for granted. Most of us focus on our health when we are ill or have had a major catastrophe in our lives when it simply might be too late. Our society has conditioned us to constantly focus on our material wealth at all costs. However, having good health is something money cannot buy. Sustainable health is a personal commitment to maintaining and taking responsibility for our own health through preventive measures. Now let us look at the five pillars of sustainable health. It includes proper diet, good sleep, stress management, fitness, and community. There is no magic short-term solution that will deliver optimal health and help us live a long and happy life. However, we treat our body today will impact our life tomorrow and into the future. This is what we believe sustainable health is all about. The best health practices can have a real impact on our well-being and life expectancy. We have more control over how long we live and how healthy we are than we possibly think. According to research, if we adopt the right lifestyle, we could add at least 10 good years and suffer a fraction of the diseases that kill us prematurely. This could mean an extra quality decade if we start taking care of the five pillars of sustainable health today. According to World Health Organization, stress is the world epidemic of the 21st century. Stress management plays a vital role in keeping sustainable health. It affects our physical, mental, and social well-being. Different types of people are affected by different types of stress. For example, for software employees, as they are mandated to work from home amid COVID-19, their stress levels have gone up as their jobs do not leave them with enough time for their families and other personal needs. Academic pressure-related stress has been identified as one of the major causes of stress in student learning process. It is one of the biggest problems faced by current students during COVID-19. And recent studies have shown that during lockdown, teachers have suffered stress from having to adapt in order to provide online classes. This stress has often been accompanied by symptoms of anxiety, depression, sleep disturbance as a consequence of the increased workload resulting from home teaching. So, what are the challenges in sustainable health? Good health for all in our time requires handling of a number of challenges. Could be demographic changes, empowerment of citizens, changing illness patterns, traumatic events, and organizational condition. The purpose of the knowledge environment sustainable health is to tackle these societal challenges, promoting health and well-being for all people of all. Now, let us look at the solutions for sustainable health. One is telemedicine, which is a rapidly developing application of clinical medicine, where medical information of a patient is transferred through the phone or the internet and sometimes other networks for the purpose of consulting and sometimes remote medical procedures or examinations. A few decades ago, a simple request for medical advice could be obtained by finding a fixed line telephone and dialing into the clinic where a physician was located. With the availability of mobile voice over internet protocol technology, one can now simply pick up a mobile phone and place a video enabled call to a physician. The physician need not necessarily have to be situated inside the clinic in order to provide advice. For example, a specialist at a North Carolina University hospital was able to diagnose a rural patient's hairline spinal fracture at a distance using telemedicine video imaging. The patient's life was saved because treatment was done on site without physically transporting the patient to the specialist who was located a greater distance away. Another way to keep our health fit is yoga. It's a healing system consisting of breathing exercises, physical postures, and meditation practiced for over 5,000 years. It is believed to calm the nervous system and balance the body, mind, and spirit. India has given the best gift to the world through yoga. As we progress in technology and sciences, the balance between human beings and nature needs to be balanced sustainably. The physical and mental well-being of humans will work to support nature to flourish and grow. The calmness we are finding outside is within us that we need to realize, which is only possible with the help of yoga. The concept of health in terms of yoga is beyond physical means and leads to the mental well-being of a person, which further gives results in the sustainable health of mankind. The goals set by the United Nations are working towards this sustainable growth of every living being on earth, and yoga plays a key role in it. Meditation is considered a type of mind-body complementary medicine. It can produce a deep state of relaxation and a tranquil mind. We all know that a healthy mind contributes to a healthy body. So, practicing yoga and meditation would prevent many diseases. I would like to end my presentation with a small quote. Person who has health has hope. Person who has hope has a world. I would like to thank International Institute of Organized Research, India, for giving me an opportunity to share my views on Sustainable Development Goal 3. These are the references.